Hey guys, it's me, being lazy on a chair today. So class is going to be the same as it is every week, with a bit of a warm-up, bit of creative tasks. I'm not going to teach too much this week, just because usually by the end of a term we're either getting ready for a performance, or I've been teaching you something, and a lot of like the last week is me checking a lot that you've maybe got it, and we can go through bits that you're unsure of. So it's just a time for me to be a little bit lazier and grab a cup of tea. I said it's a rapport as well, so I'm really sorry if you're also in rapport and have already heard that funny joke. It's not funny. So this week I'd like you to do your warm-up phrases, so your foot one and your back warm-up. We are going to change them up next term, I think. I haven't decided yet whether I want to add on or just change them completely, so to help me out, I would really like you guys to have a think about what kind of things you do as a warm-up, or what you would like to do as a warm-up, and just give me ideas. So foot warm-ups are really essential, because to be able to warm up our feet, our ankles, our legs and everything, obviously we use them quite a lot, and if we were in the studio, being able to do a lot of like throwing ourselves about, because I love doing that. We'd also really need to warm up our whole bodies with lots of jumping and back warm-ups, and like just core strengthening. So have a little think about what kind of things you would do in a warm-up, and give me some ideas, because then I can have a look at what we might want to do as a warm-up next term. Otherwise, again, it's always my ideas, which is fine for me, but I just want your input sometimes. So yeah, do your two warm-ups for me. The first creative task we've got is a 9 counts, which I really want you to just have a look at. So it's the one where we initially started it with spots. So let me find the music. This one, I'll just count it quick. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 1, 2, 3. Hopefully we've got that time in. So I provided a task last week where I got you to pick out 2 random versions. And then I rolled my dice, and it kind of randomly gave you the next steps on how you were then going to make that 18 count phrase into like a new phrase that's your own. So we've kind of developed it from that beginning of the jumping with like the turns into movement. So instead of it just being like a hop hop, I changed mine to a throw. Don't know what you guys have done, but you would have developed it yourselves into a new version. So we're redeveloping it again, so that now we've kind of had the original version, my development idea, 2 of your development ideas, and then we've randomly picked 2 out, which then makes another version. So it's kind of like a multiplied version of the original. Hopefully that makes sense. So you should now have that kind of started. So even if you've only just picked out the 2 pieces that you're going to do, that's fine. Have a look at what we had decided with the dice rolling from last week. So check the Word document and just go through practicing that, because there are things like repetition, changing the level of movements, adding in pauses, which now means that the 2 counts of 9 that you originally had now won't be 2 counts of 9. It might actually, instead of being 18 counts, it might have turned into 24 counts, 25 counts, whatever you've ended up with. So once you've understood how that kind of has kind of remolded itself, go back to the music and practice it with the music as many times as you can, just so you get that timing right, because I would then really love you to video it so I can see how much it has changed from my original just jumping and hopping to it being a dance, because it will actually really help you guys also to see how much and easy it is to just develop movement from something really simple like hopping and jumping. So once you've done that, video that for me just so I can see how we've done. And then the next thing we're going to do is just our Y oak, so the floor exercise, but that can come once you've finished your creative task. So yeah, that's it for now. Go away, practice your warm-ups, have a think about what kind of things you might want to warm up, and let me know. Either you can let me know on a Zoom, or you can message. So if you message Fee, Fee can then pass it on to me through WhatsApp. or you can write it in an email and that could be passed to me, whatever you decide you want to do. And then do the first creative task with our 9 county stuff, video that, come back, and then we'll do the floor exercise, that the little floor dance that we started, and I'll explain how you guys have inputted into that without realising. See you in a minute. Hello, so the next part of our class is the floor exercise. So we started kind of adding on to it last week, so I'm not gonna go through it slowly again this week just because we did that last week, but it's okay if you do need to go back because you can't maybe remember it, or you just need help going through all the material. So the really good thing about us already having the video is that you can just pop back to last week's and go through it there, and then once you feel more confident you can come back to this week's and just do it with me and the music. We are then going to just finish my little bit, and then I'm going to explain how what you've already been choreographing can be added into the next bit. So just in case you need a reminder of the song, it is Milk and Honey by White Oak. When it focuses, there we go. So that's the album cover, just in case you need it. So remember, it starts on the floor and you need enough room to be able to, you know, do your swings and things. So make sure you've moved all kind of dangers out of the way. And just to remind you, I'm still in the garage. So I'll try and do it as best as I can in my confined space. But if you've got much bigger room, then go for it. You know, make your moves much bigger, stretch those arms, really, you know, get them swings going. So yeah, on the floor, guys. Ready? We swing 1. We swing 2. We swing 3. Sit up, lie down. Sit up over the top. 3. Move you up a tiny, tiny bit. Lucky did the very last bit wrong, so it should scoop round in step, bum, bum. I kind of think I went step back with both of them, but it's not, it's kind of like back, forward, forward. I feel wonky now. There we go. So one of the things I asked you to do last week was play around with the timing, because it's so like boom, boom, boom. I wanted some excitement in it. So for example, this at the moment goes 1, 2, 3, 4 round, yeah. Well, actually it comes on 5, 6, 7, 8. So instead, you know, you could do 1 and 2 and round there, or the body roll could be like 1, 2, 3 and 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, instead of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, yeah. So it's just maybe speeding some of it up, maybe adding a pause in at like a really good opportunity. So at the moment I've got my pause here, but if you hate the pause there, could you put the pause in somewhere else? I think I asked you to change like the drop, because I'm not keen on that and I still don't know what to put there. So if you have any ideas, obviously send them through, let me know on Zoom, whatever. So I'm just going to play the very last bit of the music again. I think it's about 8 counts we've got left, so we haven't got much to learn this week. So I'm just going to try and find the music. So I think it goes from the body roll. Thank you. 6, 8, so let's move it, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, done. So nice and easy, it's only about 8 counts left. So once we've done the scoot round into your belly, back, forward, up, you kind of do what we did in, and I still feel like we can't think what it's called, 1,000 Years, that's the song we did it to, you know, where we kind of did it to a side and we kind of went like dun dun dun, a bit like salsa-y. So it's similar to that, so we go scoot round, in, step, back, forward, you kind of do like a wiggle, but your knees are going to go like 1, 2. I'm just going to switch us over a little bit. Okay, that's better. So, just moving us around a little bit. So, we've just done a bum, bum, bum. You kind of go like 1, 2. So you do a similar thing, but instead you'll kind of bring your shoulder to shoulder like that, and your knee kind of comes cross and cross. If you would like to kind of make it more of a move, you can go like bum, bum. So it's a little bit jazzy, but that's cool. Here, here, I know you really need to like twist your body like that. So this is like 1 and 2. So you've gone 5, 6, 7 and 8, 1 and 2. Your hands come to here, 2. You come around, 3, 4. At the same time, your hands, instead of coming around with you like this, they kind of push the opposite way. Ooh. Which is weird, so I'm going to do it just with our with our body. So our body goes round like this and our hands go round like that, so it's kind of like they're pushing away from each other. I can't do it without thinking. So here we go, 1 and 2, 3, 4. Yeah, so my feet aren't moving, the only thing that's moving is the top of my body and my arms. So 3, 4, you then go 5, 6 is like a twist, 5, 6, although it's not 5, 6, it's like a 5 and, because the beats are really slow, I keep doing that. So 7, 8, 1 and 2, 3, 4, 5 and, so 5 and, I think I did my arms out last time, do something with the arms, anything you want, so 5 and 6. So it's kind of like angles, so you are bending your knee but at the same time your elbow is kind of like lifting up here. So we've gone 5 and 6, 7 and 8, 1 and 2, 3, 4, 5, and that's what it is, 5 and 6. Come around 7, so it's kind of like you're opening up. I'm just going to bring you down so you can see my leg. So here, after we've gone twist twist, here you kind of come back up because you're going to sweep across. So it's a little bit like the swings we do on the floor. It's going to come across and open out like that, so your whole body kind of becomes open. So round here, if you can keep this foot off the floor, amazing. If you want to drag it, only drag your toe, because I kind of want to see like everything out and really stretched, because this is all like so minute that this should really open up. Now I don't have a lot of room, but what I would like is like a bit of a lean, not massively, just a little bit of a one, because it really opens up your chest so that you can kind of like drag it around a little bit. Whew. Obviously practice, because you need the momentum. So it comes round here, and then I think that is the very end of it, so let's just practice that together with the music. I'll do it once without. So we've just done 5 and 6, 7 and 8, 1 and 2, round 3, 4, twist 5 and 6, round 7, 8. If there is another beat there, because I can never count this music because it's so slow. Round, as you come round, I'd like you to wrap here. So it kind of carries on the momentum of going round. You get to here, you wrap like you're kind of grabbing yourself back to standing. Let's try that little bit with the music from, let's go from like the body roll out, flip around, because that's the only bit in the music I can find. It's coming up, seven, body roll, two, eight, round one, four, seven, eight, one, twist, twist, come, cool. Fab. The music's really peculiar. So the timing is always slightly different when I teach it to when we dance it. So that's fine, because you go with it. So once you've got the music, the movement, practice it with the music, because you will find rhythms in it and you'll find places where you quite like to stop. The only thing I would really, really love is for this to flow the whole way until you can stop. So now you've got that bit. The next bit you're going to do is the music. I keep saying music, but I don't know why. So the movement you've done with the Swan Lake workshop stuff, you've developed that into something your own. You practiced it a couple of times with different music last week. Well, the reason I wanted you to do that was just so you didn't get used to the same kind of beats with it, because what you are now going to do is add it in to this piece of dance. So I'm going to play you the music. It will go to. It's really easy to find because the music kind of goes like or something like that. Oh, I've gone blurry. I'm back. It was like a vision into how I see without my glasses on then. So this is the music. So this is our music where I've just taught this bit. Yeah, really loud. So it's really obvious which bit's yours. So it's still the same beat, but just a bit like fuller. So yeah, it goes on forever. So you've hopefully got at least 16 counts of that. Play around with it if you want to play around with it again, because I know some of you got some really fantastic movement ideas, like arms and turns. So now really get it to flow and stop. So play around with that kind of feeling of it flowing, it stopping, it becoming like really liquidy, and then suddenly it's like robots again. So play around with that. Yeah, so that's your last little creative task for this week. Have fun with it. Have an amazing May half term, and I will see you in another week. Bye.